say that if you just want to hear the songs, you can always stay home and put on a CD or a Spotify station, whatever it is everybody does these days. But if you want to get to know an artist a little bit better, it's good to come down to the theater. It gives us a chance to get to know you a little better. And I like to share stories. It's just in my nature. And so just something that you may not know is I was born and raised in Chicago, Illinois. I'm the firstborn male in an Irish Catholic family, and as such, there was always an expectation that I would, of course, become a Catholic priest. And it made sense to me when I was in about the sixth grade, and so I was an altar boy, and Pope Francis would have been proud of me, man, you know. I dig that dude, you know what I mean? He's kind of a cool pope. I think he's the first cool pope I've ever seen. But at any rate, what they do when they want to get you into the priesthood is they try to kind of feed you the vows that you have to take slowly. They don't want to freak you out. They start with things like the vow of piety. Like, who knows what that is? You know, the vow of poverty. You know, I didn't have any money anyway. What did I care? And then when I got into the seventh grade, I was taken by the vow of puberty. Which, strictly speaking, is not a vow of the Catholic Church, but nevertheless, it is something that is undeniable. It takes a hold of a young boy and changes everything. And it was right about that time that they introduced the final vow. They saved the best for last. The final vow, of course, the vow of chastity. Had they told us about the vow of chastity in sixth grade, I wouldn't have known what they were talking about. But by the seventh grade, I knew exactly what it was going to be that I was going to be expected to give up for the rest of my life. And as such, I decided at that moment, it was like a flash from the heavens, like lightning came down and like beams of sun came from behind a dark storm cloud. And I realized at that moment that I, from that moment forward, would of course be a member of the Church of Rock and Roll! And I'll tell you, it's a good thing that I made that decision, because had I not, I would have never had a girlfriend, and if I would have never had a girlfriend, I would have never fallen in love, and if I would have never fallen in love, my heart would never have been broken, and had my heart never been broken, I would never have written the following song.
Direction.